Commissioner is dead. Buhari mourns. Mr. Shehu said President Muhammad Buhari also mourned the deceased, who is a former federal lawmaker. President Muhammad Buhari extends heartfelt condolences to Governor Yahaya Bello of Kogi State on the passing of Honorable Suleiman Kokori Abdul, federal commissioner representing Kogi State in the Revenue Mobilization Allocation and Fiscal Commission. The president also commiserates with the chairman and member of the commission on the demise of the federal commissioner, who was sworn in June 2019. As a homebred politician and former member representing Okene Oguri Magogo constituency in the 6th National Assembly 2007 to 2011, President Buhari avers that Honorable Abdul understood the place of dedication and compassion in public service, and this earned him admiration and respect in politics as well as among his people. The president recognizes the contribution of the late federal commissioner to the administration's drive to mobilize revenue from the non-oil sector, and hopes that his dedication to duty will continue to inspire the work of the RMAFC. President Buhari says his thoughts are with the Abdul family during this time of mourning, even as he prays Almighty Allah to forgive the shortcoming of the deceased and bless him with Aljana Fadaus. Thank you for listening to this news. Well, what do we expect from the president? The only thing he's going to say is sorry. Nothing more than that. And the same statement of Buhari mourn will still come up. But the truth is that, is he truly mourning? You understand? Is President Buhari truly mourning? You get it? No, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that the president is wishing anybody dead. But President Buhari, in this his administration has recorded tremendous deaths of politicians, commissioners, ministers. Can we count the people that have died in Aso Rock? Can you count them? They are uncountable. Dignitaries. And sometimes, I used to say that sometimes these people are the cause of their death. See, there is always an age limit for someone to leave office. There is always an age limit for someone to be in office and also to leave office. When you have seen that you have crossed that age of being still remaining in office, why don't you humbly step down? Why don't you humbly leave office and allow the young to come on and have a rest and enjoy the little money that you have made? But out of greed and wickedness and self-centeredness, you still want to remain in office to clock 100. Still be in office carrying out activities and responsibilities that are supposed to be carried out by the young people. Why won't you die? You will. You can imagine the person of Abakiari that is over 80 something years, still in office,
as chief of staff, what is he still doing? Is he not supposed to leave the office for the young people to come in? Another person is the army chief of staff, Brotai. That one, I'm not talking about his age now, but I'm talking about this the years he has spent in office. The years he has spent in office as overdue. So he's supposed to leave office for the young to come in. So these people are the ones killing themselves. Why won't they die? Why won't they? They will definitely die when they are supposed to leave an office for people that are still very young to come up and manage. Go to Aso Rock. If you can be able to count the people that if you can be able to see the young ones occupying any sensitive position, the people you will see occupying sensitive position are those in the age bracket of 60 to 80 years of age. And when you talk to them, they will tell you that it's based on experience. Are you trying to tell me that someone at the age of 40 years doesn't have experience? Are you trying to tell me that someone at the age bracket of 50 doesn't have experience? It is great that it's still making someone at the age of 70, 80 years to still be in office. See, left me alone. Once you are clocked 80 years, you should just not even think of going in for presidency or governorship. You should just go and have a seat and sit down and enjoy the little money you have made. And allow the young ones to come into office and do the needful. You understand? Unlike, look at the President Muhammadu Buhari now. He's over 80. He's over 80. So you can say that military spirit is no longer in him again. That is why our country is suffering today. Yes, that's why we are suffering. But we are not saying that. We think that he's doing us good. We never knew that he's causing harm to us. We never knew. This is very serious, so, and we really need to look into it with lot of seriousness. With lot of seriousness. My viewers, it's paining me because despite all that Nigerian has gone through, yet we have refused to give ourselves some atom of sense. Well, your comments are also very much important at this case. Deem it fit to leave them below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.